Dear students, in previous classes we have discussed a few topics on electricity, so like the concept of electric potential, electric field, the lines of force, the Coulomb's law, then the Gauss law and the application of Gauss law in some typical cases when there is spherical symmetry, like a charge distribution of spherical shape, or in case of a cylindrical charge distribution, like some infinitely long wire, or in case of a plane which is infinitely extended, a charged plane, and so on. And during those classes I told you that we will discuss flux. We mentioned flux in some cases because the Gauss law comes about estimating the total flux outward and enclosure. I told you in that class. So, and we need to understand flux in a better way. So, this is just a very special small note on flux, and this is primarily prepared from the Berkeley physics course. Say, we are considering a river. This is a river, like these dotted lines, they are river. River flow, and water is flowing along this direction with a velocity v. Note that it is assumed kind of, say, at any particular point the velocity is v, which does not change in respect of time, but this velocity v may change from place to place. Say at this point is this velocity is v, it is v every time, but if you are if you go to a different point, say here the velocity at this point, say here the velocity may be u or w, whatever, that means other than v. So now we consider an area, an elementary area, and this area is indicated by an outward normal on that area. So, the outward normal here is denoted by A. This is a vector quantity, so that is why the mark above A. This should be an arrow, however you take it. Well, if you place the area perpendicular to the flow of motion, if the area is held perpendicular to the flow of motion, then the normal on the area is parallel to the flow of motion, and A is normal on that area. A is perpendicular on this area, so A has to be parallel to B. And in that case, the flux is defined as B into A. What it means, I will say it later. If the plane is held, if the area is held parallel to the flow of motion, that means the area is perpendicular to B. The outward normal to the area A, this A vector is parallel, perpendicular to B, then the flux is zero. And if it is set in any arbitrary angle theta, then the flux is VA cos theta. You can simply do it from typical concepts of classical mechanics and vectors. Perhaps you have all have done this in higher secondary level. Note that as these three elementary areas are not placed in three different places, though they are drawn this way. Eta left sided hoyeche in the left side, this is in the middle position, and this is in the extreme right part. But everywhere I use the velocity v. As I told you, velocity changes from place to place. Er mane ami kintu actually etake same jaygate dekhachi. Eta kind of ekta picture, eta arekta picture, third picture at same place. Note it. Or if you want to write it in a different way, that three areas in three different places, then just change the value of the velocity. If it is v1 here, then it is v2, but still it will be 0, and if it is v3, then it will be v3 a cos theta. I think you got my point. If not, please let me know and write to me. And in case of a flowing river, jeta amra ekhane consider korlam, we consider a flowing river here, v velocity of water, a being the outward normal on any elementary area imagined within the water river, the flux is phi w, w denotes water, phi w is v dot a, that means rate of flow of water through the area. Amount of water flowing through the area per unit time, the volume of water, that means the unit has to be meter cube. It also comes from here, it is meter per second and it is meter square. The area denotes the meter square. And now, just remember that this concept of flux is applicable for every vector quantity. In this case, we have considered the velocity vector. It is applicable for any other vector. And if we consider the electric field, then in case of an area within the electric field, it is the field vector. You just check that these are the these lines, they are the lines of force in the electric field. You remember this. And this A, I'm sorry, this A area, say we assume an arbitrary shape of enclosed surface. This S is an enclosed surface. We assume this surface, it like a balloon. You know, amra balloon dekhechi, balloon er upper surface, jeta it subtends the volume, and there is an outer surface of the balloon. So this is, we may imagine that we are drawing a very small piece of area. Just we take a sketch pen and draw a shape, maybe just an enclosed shape. This area, this may be a square, a rectangle, doesn't matter, a circular shape or a pentagon or a triangular shape, whatever, an elementary area. Then this AJ vector denotes this particular area, and AJ vector is perpendicular to this area. And at that point of time, point in space, we consider that the field is EJ. That means J by J, J sub J index, we denote the jth part of elementary area. So AJ, just know this, AJ is outward normal on the elementary area, and it does not depend on the shape of the area, as I told you, triangular, rectangular, whatever. And this elementary area is so small, we consider it very small, that it is considered as a plane. Though the balloon or any arbitrary shape, say a football or a globe, they are curved surfaces, but this area is sufficiently small to be considered as a plane surface. And as it is not a particular point, but an extension in two-dimensional space, this area, so you may think that the electric field at this corner of the area may be different from the electric field at this corner. But thing is not that. As this area is sufficiently small, the field is almost same, and we consider it to be same at every point on the elementary area. That is the needed thing. So the flux, according to our definition here, as we understood here, the flux through that arbitrary area, a arbitrary area diye, the flux through that arbitrary area is EJ dot AJ, that means area. Therefore, now you consider another ith area at this place. Say you consider another area here. You consider another area here, and whatever way you like, you consider another area here. And so what happens? By this way, you complete the entire surface by considering elementary areas, A1, A2, A3, A4, and so on to AJ, and you cover the entire surface S by such elementary areas. So the total flux throughout the entire enclosure, that means S is phi equal to Ej dot Aj summed over J. And you know, if we consider Aj to be infinitesimally small, it has to be small, it is not smaller. Infinitesimally small, then A is denoted by dA, because this is infinitesimally small and the flux will be through that area Ej dot Aj. Look at here. The flux will be, if the area is infinitesimally small, then this Aj will be written as dAj. That means this A will be replaced by dA, and you know, for infinitesimally small area, we convert the summation sign by an integration sign. So, the total flux will be integration over the entire surface E dot dA. That is the definition of flux. Thank you.